Good morning, everybody. Very good morning. Welcome on Karel's webinar. My name is Sebastiano Di Lena. I am a group marketing manager for food retail. Today I'm here with
Marco Fusca. I'm the application manager for plugin and semi-plugin application with special focus on natural refrigerant solution.
Okay, today we will going to present to you the EOS Box CO2, and the title of the presentation is Think Outside of the EOS Box, because we would like to present the product but also the augmented dimension around the product. So we would like to let you think a little bit outside the product itself, so the box itself. The presentation is about 30-40 minutes, and we prefer to answer to your questions at the end of the presentation through the box of the question and answer. This is because some of the questions maybe have already the answer during the presentation. So please collect your doubts, and we can go even back to some slide if you needed some specific information. So let's check the agenda. We will have an application background in order to put everybody on the same page. It is important, the application background, because I underline again, we would like you to think outside the box. Then we will think about the box, so we will speak about the product and the services connected to the product, and then we will end up with the conclusion, summing up what we have seen today. So I let Marco begin, and in this journey, 30-40 minutes.
Okay, thanks Sebastiano. So before coming more in detail about the product and before giving you some snapshot about the services that we have decided to provide together with the condenser unit that we are going to present, some pills about the background. We are talking about a condenser unit for a food retail application. I would say that the unit can be used in all the supermarket sites, from convenience to hypermarket. It's a vertical for the complete management of refrigerated cabinet, refrigerated showcase, but can be used thanks to the fact that we have a wide cooling capacity range also for cold rooms. You know that we have two kinds of approach when we talk about refrigeration for food retail. We have centralized systems where a remote cabinet are served by a common compressor rack, and we have decentralized systems. A decentralized approach means that self-contained cabinets are equipped with a compressor on board. Talking about self-contained cabinets, we can divide plug-in, that means air-cooled, for semi-plug-in, that means water-cooled. This is just to become familiar also with the wording. Our EOS Box is a semi-plug-in solution that is intended to work with a water loop system. Water loop system means the possibility, and we will see what kind of advantage this can provide, means the possibility to put outside the store the heat rejection. Before going more in detail about the product, some snapshot about what is the refrigerant scenario that we can use for self-contained unit. We have two main drivers that are, I would say, changing deeply, are bringing a revolution into our market. On one side, we have the legislation driver, so the limitation of GWP. We know that in Europe we have the F-gas, so the limitation of a quota. It is going to become more and more restrictive. We have also the operation and service costs that are being more and more severe due to the legislation for those installation that are exceeding the GWP quota. And clearly we have also taxes and incentives that are moving towards what? Towards the research of low GWP refrigerants. On the other side, we have the market drivers that are basically summarized by safety, energy efficiency, and clearly a sustainability of the solution. So when we talk about the research of low GWP refrigerant, basically we have to move with three pillars, as we know. The attention to the environment, simplifying at the maximum the GWP installed, but also safety and also affordability, meaning with affordability, efficiency on one side and low life cycle cost on the other one. In this table, we have summarized what are the refrigerant options that currently can be used for self-contained unit. We have basically A2R refrigerants on one side, and on the other, we have the natural option, CO2 and propane. In a qualitative way, keeping the baseline for keeping R448A as a baseline, so keeping a traditional HFC refrigerant as a baseline, we've tried to give a qualitative overview about the pros and the cons of using the different options. If we talk about GWP, it's clear the great advantage of the propane and CO2 solutions that are fully natural. They are, without doubt, future-proof. Today, I remember the limitation is in terms of GWP is around the number 150. Okay, so VATUL seems to be a valid solution, but I invite you to think about what could happen in the future if this threshold is lowered futurely. In terms of availability and cost of a refrigerant, the consideration are quite similar. CO2 and propane make possible to have a better sustainability in terms of cost of a refrigerant and availability, easiness of finding the refrigerant in the market. If we go more in detail about the technical point very quickly, we start to have some differences. And knowing the background, in my opinion, is very important to understand the reason why we have developed this kind of product, the EOSBox CO2.
Yeah, so if I look at this slide and I try to rephrase it in a very short synthesis, I look at this and I see that there is the HUL column, which could be okay, but it is not future-proof because of the limitation of the GWP, which could be even lower in the next future. And propane on the other side is an excellent refrigerant, is inflammable. So flammable, so we have particular handle for that. CO2 is a good solution. We have to distinguish between subcritical and transcritical conditions, because in both cases, in transcritical conditions, we can overcome some pressure issues and performance issues with technology, so increasing a little bit the complexity, while on subcritic, it is excellent, but you have to be in subcritic condition. And now we see the difference and how to manage these different situations.
Exactly. In a very qualitative way, from a safety point of view, CO2 has a great advantage because it's an A1 refrigerant. In terms of pressure, it's important to distinguish from subcritic and transcritic. Clearly, transcritic means working with high pressure, and this is a cons of the CO2 in transcritical operation. If we go more in detail about the COP, so the efficiency of the system, that is, I would say, strictly related also to the cost of the system, when we talk about CO2, we think that it can be a valid alternative to propane, especially in subcritic condition, and we will explain why.
Yeah, maybe in the next slide we explain.
Exactly. In order to withstand with the limitation that we will see the CO2 has in transcritical condition, we need to add technology. CO2 has excellent thermodynamic properties. Without going in details about the thermodynamics feature and the chemical properties of the CO2, I just want to underline that the CO2 in subcritical condition has the highest specific cooling capacity among all the other refrigerant options. We know that in transcritical condition, due to the fact that the low temperature the critical temperature of the CO2 is quite low, we face limitation in terms of the efficiency of the system. So we start to find some performance barriers. And we know that these performance barriers can be improved thanks to technology. So we can introduce the technology. Adding technology means clearly introducing complexity on one side and clearly also affecting the cost of the solution. Here is summarized what are the three main performance barriers that we can find. High heat rejection losses due to the fact that we cannot condensate in transcritical condition, and we know the optimal COP algorithm that can be used. In low temperature application, due to the high differential pressure, we need to introduce the double stage compression. And in order to manage, and this is very important, I will stress in the following slide the concept. In order to manage high throttling losses, usually it's required a free valve design. So to separate the evaporator side from the high pressure side. Think that this will affect the possibility to manage a possible multi-evaporator configuration in a self-contained unit. Will be more clear in the next slide. What I'm trying to say is that dealing with CO2, that is an excellent refrigerant, means finding a compromise between efficiency on one side and complexity and cost on the other one. Since our EOSBox CO2 is a unit designed, as we will see, for subcritical operation, we need cold water. Cold water requires clearly a chiller. Here we have summarized what are the main components of a water loop system suitable for managing our EOSBox CO2. And we have tried to specify the reason why we think that the CO2 in subcritical condition can be a very efficient alternative to propane. I want to add that having cold water enable also new possibilities in order to boost not only the efficiency of the self-contained unit itself, but the overall efficiency of the system. And this thanks to the fact that we can create synergies. Here we have just indicated two design tips that can be used for when you have a cold water loop. We can have basically a smart integration with the AC utilities, so with the HVAC system on one side, and you can have also heat reclaim option.
In the previous slides, when there was written a free cooling chiller, of course, adding to a free cooling chiller. You can even stay here. Adding in a free cooling chiller, a heat exchanger opens different possibilities, like the integration with the air conditioning system or the heat reclaim rejection, taking advantage of this heat. And this is very important because when we work in a subcritical condition and we have to keep a certain amount of cold water, we have on the other side a certain amount of warm vector that can be used in different way. We have some examples, but I also suggest to think outside the box and the system and find other way to use this heat rejection. For example, you can also sell to the neighbor in a holistic approach to the managing of heating and cooling.
Yeah, what we are trying to say is that CO2 in subcritical condition means exceptional efficiency, but this efficiency can also boost by a smart integration of the refrigerating system with all the other possible requirements that we can find for the stores, but also for, I would say, the district where the store is located. Very quickly, some snapshot about the main difference between centralized and decentralized in terms of benefits and advantages, just to introduce the product. It's just a matter of a couple of minutes. The great difference between a decentralized approach, so in this case a water loop system, compared to a traditional rack, is the fact that the unit can be directly controlled, and the cooling capacity that is required to each specific condenser unit installed on that specific cabinet is exactly the one demanded by that cabinet. Just for making a more technical example, the evaporating temperature self-adjusts according to the effective working condition. So in a water loop application, we don't need to have all the compromise that we can find in a rack system, where a common suction pressure shall be used for managing the different requirements, and clearly the cooling demand of the whole system is strictly related to the most demanding cabinets. Clearly, having self-contained design make possible also to have limited pressure drops because of self-contained design itself. And clearly, having a small refrigerating circuit means reduce drastically the risk of leakage and also give flexibility in terms of easy layout modification of the store. All these advantages are boosted by the HEOS technology that is well known since we have, as we will see in the next slide, a long experience in terms of DC technology applied to self-contained units. So very quickly, HEOS technology, that means variable speed compressor on one side, stepper valve on the other one, everything synchronized by our HEOS controller, means efficiency thanks to the full continuous modulation concept. Our HEOS box CO2 is ease of use, is easy to be used and to be integrated thanks to the fact that the units are pre-configured and we make available, and we will see, a complete set of tools. Moreover, we have introduced a new frontier in terms of connectivity, local and also remote, wired and wireless. Yeah, we have some dedicated slide on this. And finally, clearly, having the full continuous modulation enables the possibility to improve food quality preservation. So this is just a snapshot of the benefit related to HEOS technology, plus what we have discussed in terms of using the CO2 in subcritical condition, enabling possible synergies relating to the wall installation, and clearly all the benefit of a decentralized solution itself. This slide is just a summary of the long path that we have seen across the years. We are talking about more than 10 years of evolution.
Yeah, actually, we have written 10 years of evolution. Maybe we can also rephrase in 10 years of experience, by the way.
Yeah, DC experience. This year, we are presenting the HEOS box CO2. And now, I think we are ready to go more in detail about the solution itself, giving before just some snapshot about the whole HEOS CO2 lineup. We have components, and this is, let me say, our first approach. And through components, we are capable to manage all the applications that we can find in the market, not only subcritical, but also transcritical. I just want to underline that we have a unique solution that is also under patent, that makes us possible to manage with a single valve configuration and a single stage compressor, medium temperature application in transcritical condition. So keeping the system very simple and also very simple, and also to control the cost of the solution itself. We have enabled with the HEOS box also the possibility to acquire the full condenser unit. We have done a choice. We have tried to explain why we have done this choice. This unit is capable to work in subcritical condition. In this slide, you can see the advantage of having subcritical condition. With a single valve design, with a single stage compressor, you can deal both medium temperature and low temperature unit. And moreover, you can also enable the multi-evaporator configuration. Finally, let's see some details about the product itself.
Let's go into the product.
Yeah. Very, very quickly.
So what is it, HEOS box?
What is the HEOS box? We have said that the HEOS box is a water cooled condenser unit. We have already anticipated that the HEOS box has been designed to work in some critical operation. So we have a single valve design and we have a single stage compressor. We have several models, as we will see, single stage. The cooling capability is up to 14 kilowatt medium temperature and up to 6 kilowatt low temperature. This extended range is thanks to the subcritical behavior. We have four models available, four EOSBox CO2 models available, and we are capable to deal both with single and multi-evaporator configuration. So from the components and know-how, basically we have added the option of acquiring the full condenser unit, entirely concealed and developed by Carel. The development of the unit has been done in our laboratory and took more than 1 year of R&D and validation activities. I just want to underline that the test and the R&D activity has been done in a real application.
Real cabinets. Like the ones I see in the pictures.
Exactly. We have a store in our lab where the unit has run for more than 1 year. We have already some early adopters that has installed the unit. So we are in the early adoption phase just because we are launching the product. But I just want to underline that the unit has been already tested in a real application and we are just finalizing the product in terms of availability in the market. Coming more in detail about the product portfolio, basically we have four EOSBox models that can be coupled with unipolar stepper valves to be installed on the evaporator. We have a display option. This display can be installed in the cabinet, and this display is compliant with wireless connectivity, as we will see better in the next slides. I mean, Bluetooth and NFC option. And then we have also some accessories. We have a secondary panel for multi-evaporator configuration, will be more clear in the next slide. And we have also a kit gateway, a special kit that allows us to have a wireless connectivity to the supervisory system. Basically, we are talking about a Wi-Fi serial converter. Some snapshot about the refrigerating circuit. Without going in detail, I just want to underline what are the safeties that we have decided to adopt. We have three levels of safety. We have first an envelope control that is capable to slow down the compressor in case of pressure increasing. And this is the first level. Then we have a pressure switch that is capable to shut down the unit in case of future increase of a pressure that cannot be withstand with the envelope control. And then we have also a safety valve that is set at the design pressure of a unit, that is 80 bar. Why this different level of safety, and also why we decided to use the 80 bar? Just because we want to avoid at all any possibility of an unwanted release of CO2 in the store, even in case of any possible critical situation in the water loop. So this is a design choice that we have done. What are the evaporator configuration that we can manage? Clearly a single evaporator configuration, so one unit serving each specific cabinet, but we have also the possibility to manage multi-evaporator configuration. I want to underline that the multi-evaporator can be managed without changing the part numbers, because the unit are not provided with oil separator. And the reason is why we have developed some specific logics tested. And I would anticipate probably also under patenting that can allow us to have a safety behavior of a unit in guaranteeing a good oil recovery, even if in a multi-evaporator approach, without the need of oil separator.
So the end benefit is that with one box and three panels, you can control three evaporators, so you reduce the cost, actually.
Yeah, you just need one EOS box that can be installed on, let's call it the main evaporator. And we just need two secondary panels, that is the accessory that I anticipated, that is just for the managing of the showcase from a functional point of view. But the refrigerant circuit is in common. This configuration can be useful, in my opinion, to make more sustainable the cost of the implementation of a solution clearly. Some pills about the compressor. We have four models from 3 to 10 cc displacement. This DC compressor, this BLDC compressor have a modulating range from 25 to 100 RPS. Are compressor all in PED category 1 for an easy path, certification path, I would say. All of these are have a suction liquid separator embedded, so I would say boosting furtherly the safety in terms of liquid return prevention. And the twin rotary design make possible to have not only a compact design, the unit is has an 8 lower than 25 centimeters, but also to keep under control the noise very well. Another pill about our software distinctive feature is the fact that thanks to the DC technology, thanks to the fact that we have engineered the unit, we can have a real-time COP calculation, which is a new software distinctive feature.
And this can be used in predictive, as a kind of predictive, one of the axes of the predictive maintenance, yeah. Let's say.
This enable predictive maintenance possibilities, as we will try to explain quickly in the service section.
Right.
So what are the performance and operating range? The evaporating range is from minus 32 up to 3 degrees Celsius. So I would say without limitation in terms of the common application that we can find in a store. The brine temperature that can be accepted for working in subcritical condition is 0 up to 18 degrees Celsius.
Which is again nothing new for whatever kind of AC chiller, for example.
Exactly. The capacity range medium temperature is up to 14 kilowatt medium temperature, and the capacity range for low temperature is up to 6 kilowatt, as I tried to explain. The modulating range is from 25 RPS to 100 RPS, a full continuous modulation. You will find more detail about the specific performance and different working condition in the brochure that is available in our website. Some snapshot about the electrical panel. The electrical panel has a side-by-side design with a refrigerating circuit. The power supply is a single phase 230 volt for all the unit, with the exception of the biggest model that requires a three-phase 400 volt power supply. And just let me underline that the EOS controller has been specifically designed for optimizing the design of the panel. As you can see, the layout is very clean, very smooth. And these controllers has not only the possibility to manage the full circuit, but also to manage the load, and integrates also the protection for the load. That's the reason why we have developed this this controller, and this helps us to keep under control the cost for a sustainable solution.
Yeah, this is the most important thing, that reducing the complexity reduce at the end the cost of for the end user, for the OEM.
Yeah. What about the speed drivers? I prefer to talk about speed driver rather than an inverter. I would say that, as you know, we have a qualification process to perfectly match the inverter with the speed driver with the compressor. This makes us possible to have very good and precise piloting. I just want to underline two additional features. The fact that we have a full standard compliance, especially in terms of EMC requirements for an easy certification path for the unit and the unit integration into the cabinet. And we have several safety features that can improve the reliability. We have a Class B firmware that give additional electronic safeties for a locked rotor condition. I already anticipated that clearly we have an envelope control, but we have also the traditional safety that you can find in a high level inverter, and the possibility to directly connect to the inverter the pressure switch, so to have the safe, the safety to
so
off.
Also in this case we reduce the complexity and so we reduce the cost of the overall solution.
Exactly. What about the core, so the EOS controller that is synchronizing all the smart components that we have in the system, so compressor, variable speed compressor on one side through the inverter, the speed driver, and the stepper expansion valve that we have seen shall be coupled to each EOS box. Our EOS power board makes possible to have a full circuit control without any need of external device because everything is embedded, make possible to have a full showcase management, light, fans, defrost, and also to manage main secondary network in aisle synchronization functionalities. So it's a complete showcase controller. Plus what? Plus the possibility to enable advanced connectivity. Here we have we can see the remote connectivity that can be wired or wireless, as we have seen. And I want to underline that the EOS power board is ready for a wired connectivity, not only via serial Modbus, but also enables the Ethernet connectivity option for those who wants to embrace the future. And I already anticipated that we have also the remote connectivity option thanks to our Wi-Fi serial converter that can be a useful device that enables the possibility to access to the supervisory system without the need of long wiring across the store. Also this keeping under control the solution implementation cost. And then we have also the user interface that can enabling as an option, also local wireless connectivity through Bluetooth and NFC option. Before coming into the conclusion, just a few slides about the services that we have decided to introduce to support the product adoption.
We will go briefly to the services since it is a very wide and complex matter. So we gave just some snapshot of what enables the EOS box solution.
Yeah, I will try to be very, very synthetic. Due to the fact that we have continuous modulation on one side and we have engineered the unit on the other one, we have the perfect knowledge of how the system is performing. This enables what we call the drill down process. So we are fully capable to understand how that specific cabinet is operating. And once we couple our EOS box with supervisory systems and with digital services, we can easily pass from the cabinet level view to the store level view and then to the enterprise level view, enabling, for instance, a multi-site comparison. All of this is just to anticipate what such a product and such a technology can enable, that is the predictive maintenance, a true predictive maintenance. Here are just some dedicated dashboard that we have developed to support the unit introduction. And together with the unit, we have also think about a service proposal process. We support the client in the store. We can support the client in the store assessment. That means fine tuning and baseline definition. Baseline is a concept that can allow us to establish the optimum store behavior. And we can support also the store map creation that are very useful for the store manager. We can support the customer with what we have called remote monitoring, with a performance analysis that is KPI based. And we can perform the drill down analysis that I already anticipated. And then clearly we have an advanced reporting system. That means not only alarm management and not only benchmark management, but means also the possibility to have prescription and suggestion for performance optimization, the true predictive maintenance concept. And now let's go to the conclusion before
answers.
Yeah, before giving the time for eventual questions and answers. What are the benefits of the EOS box for OEMs and installers? First of all, we have already anticipated that we are talking about a future-proof solution. Our ESBox is easy to be integrated because the unit is pre-configured. We have already seen how much connectivity we can bring, both local and also remote. And additionally, we have a full standard compliance at all levels for an easy certification path. We have done the R&D activities for you, so you can cut the time to market. You can have Karel as a unique supplier, not only for the components, but for the entire product and also for the services that are embedded with the product. And clearly, you have also the Karel support in terms of reliability and quality system. Each unit is 100% tested. And for the end user, you have the value proposition that we have already seen across the presentation, but basically is summarized by four pillars: the running cost savings, thanks to the full continuous modulation, the possibility of a smart integration with HVAC, due to the fact that we have a cold water loop, ease of installation, thanks to the advanced connectivity, maintenance cost saving. We have tried to give some pills, some snapshot about the predictive maintenance that is possible thanks to our unit, and clearly the benefit in terms of food quality preservation given by the continuous modulation. So coming to the conclusion, what is the ESBox? ESBox CO2 is a condenser unit for semi-plug-in retail showcases that are connected to a cold water loop system. Having a cold water loop system enables the possibility to create synergies with the HVAC systems. There are possible some design tips that can boost not only the efficiency of each specific self-contained unit, but the efficiency of the overall system, considering also the HVAC requirements. Dealing with CO2 in subcritical condition means the possibility to have a permanently efficient working condition that are boosted by EOS technology on one side, and on the other allow us to keep the system simple, to reduce the complexity, and to keep under control the cost. ESBox CO2 is a future-proof solution, and used in a subcritical condition, we think can be a real alternative to propane cabinet. Moreover, our unit is characterized by advanced local and remote connectivity. I want to underline again, wired and wireless, and integrates digital services that make possible to enable active monitoring, data analysis, but through predictive maintenance concept that we have tried to introduce. So,
yeah. Thanks a lot, Marco. Now, before reading the question and answer, I got two questions, actually. So, first of all, when the documentation will be available?
The documentation will be available across April and May. The product will be officially launched in the next couple of weeks. It's already available in the market for...
The product itself is available in the market. Yeah. If somebody wants to try, they can order a sample and we can provide. While the documentation will be uploaded...
The documentation is going to be finalizing in the next weeks.
So if the people follow our internet site or our socials, so we will exactly say when we will it will be published on the internet site, at least the brochure, I mean.
Yeah, exactly. Little by little, the documentation will be finalized during April, but the product can be already ordered to us for early adoption, for trials, for tests, and so on.
And of course, we can support early adopters in their development phase.
Exactly.
Integration with the cabinet or field trial.
We are already doing with the partners that we have already found.
Okay. Now, I guess we can read the question and answer, the question, and then try to answer. Okay, so the question, we got one question. Does the same model can be applied for both MT and the LT?
Yeah, the answer is yes. And the reason is because we have decided to put the valve outside the ESBox. As you have seen in the first slide, the core package is done by an EOSBox unit, the condensee unit, that shall be matched with the proper expansion valve. This makes possible to have only four models to manage both medium temperature and low temperature application, reducing so the variability and making us possible to serve also with acceptable lead time, considering the overall scenario, the overall global scenario. I think it's very important to be also quick in the response time.
So actually, we had four models, four codes, and according to the type of valve, we can manage MT and LT conditions.
Exactly. You can use our CPQ tool, or you can contact our subsidiaries if you need support in choosing the valve size. But I confirm that with our unit, you can manage both medium temperature and low temperature coming with the same model, simply sizing accordingly the valve. And I underline again, the same model can work in single evaporator and multi-evaporator configuration.
Okay.
With the limitation of three evaporator managed.
There is another question, very technical one. It looks like the compressor discharge gas can get very hot, especially in LT operation. How do you deal with this? Is there any liquid injection, forced ventilation around the compressor shell?
Yeah, it's true. We don't need the liquid injection. We have co-designed this compressor and we don't need the liquid injection. This was one of the requirements. We deal with auto discharge temperature that are, I repeat, fully automatically managed by our safety inside the logic, with the help of a fan. We have a fan inside the refrigerating circuit. Maybe we can go back. Okay, it's not important, but there is a fan in the refrigerating circuit that helps us to keep low the discharge temperature, and so to avoid this kind of problem.
Okay, another question. Does the connected showcase evaporator also need to have 80 bars design pressure? Is it feasible to match the EOS box to a 60 bar showcase?
The answer is clearly yes. Clearly, you know that the overall design pressure of the system is given by the lowest design pressure of the equipment. So the answer is yes. The reason of 80 bar is because we wanted to cover all the possible problems that could occur in the water loop system without any unwanted release of CO2 in the system. So even if, for instance, the water loop stops, with 80 bar design, we are sure that we will not release with unit off any CO2 in the system.
Okay, another question. EOS Box CO2 is also for cold rooms needs.
Yeah, thanks to the fact that you are working in subcritical condition, and thanks to the fact that in subcritical condition, the CO2 has exceptional cooling capabilities, the answer is yes. As we have anticipated, you can reach up to 14 kilowatt medium temperature and up to 6 kilowatt low temperature. So in my opinion, dealing with CO2 in subcritical condition enables also the possibility to use this unit with a single unit approach also for cold rooms.
Okay, this is not a question, but a kind of consideration. So showcases require energy efficiency rating in Europe. How can you rate the CO2 semi-plug-in units when you need from 0 to 18 Celsius water inlet temperature? The testing standard requires 30 degrees. A big portion of the energy used is wasted in the chiller, which is probably not taken into account. New test procedure needed.
This is a very, very technical question related to the standard. I have the answer, but I suggest Andreas.
Yeah,
Andreas, to contact me. And I will go more in detail about the certification process and some certification tips that could be used, because it's a long It's a long story, okay. But I can anticipate that the standard are in evolution, and we don't expect to have problem to be capable to certify an installation with a certificate of operation condition.
Okay, then another question. Is the evaporator expansion valve also acting as the system hug pressure expansion valve? Is that the one valve concept?
No, it's something slightly different. It's the only valve that is present in the system and is the expansion valve at the evaporator side. Since you are dealing with subcritical condition, you have an HVC-like refrigerating circuit. So it's from a thermodynamic point of view is similar to have R410A, just to make some names, R448A, or also propane. The single valve concept that I mentioned in the EOS CO2 lineup is a concept that allows us to manage both high pressure in an optimal way in terms of the optimal COP and also the evaporator pressure, so to control also the suction superheat with a special algorithm. It's a Carrel patented algorithm, but this is applicable in transcritical condition. So it's a solution that we have in terms of component. It's out of the scope of the EOS box, that is a subcritical unit, as we have explained.
Thanks, Marco. Okay, I don't see any. Oh, yes, let's see another question. Okay, water-cooled condensing units in EU are subject to eco-design requirements. Do these units comply with the eco-design regulation?
The answer is yes. I would say that the eco-design regards the whole system, not the condensing unit itself.
It's for the cabinet, the eco-design, and not the EOS box. So the cabinet should be certified or... rated according to the eco design and eco labeling. Okay, any other questions? I don't see. Yes, please. In case of multi evaporator system, up to three evaporators with one Carrel unit, one electronic expansion valve, is it mandatory having one cabinet with the three evaporators?
I will try to answer. In case I have not catch your question, please write again. We need an evaporator, we need a stepper valve for each evaporator in order to manage the system with EOS technology. So when you have a multi-evaporator approach, you have our EOS box that is serving three different evaporators. And each evaporator shall be provided with its stepper expansion valve. So you need the one stepper expansion valve for each cabinet. I don't know if I have catch the question.
I guess so, Marco.
You can use an evaporator.
Thanks.
Okay, thanks.
Javier was underlining that the eco design regulation he was meaning for a condensing unit, but we have answered.
Yeah, the water loop systems are being integrated in the eco design. If I'm not wrong, it's something that is ongoing. We have already designed the unit thinking for the implementation, for the proper implementation in terms of eco design. So the answer is yes, even if today it's not required, because today the water loop are still in, let me say, that gray area, I would say.
Okay, another question raised up. First of all, thanks for the presentation. Thank you for attending. When the equipment is turned off and the ambient temperature is 35 degrees, the pressure inside the system is about 80 bar. Is there a need for a safety system for when the equipment is turned off?
The safety standards require to have a discharge system. So we have our unit are equipped with a port, with a threaded port that makes possible to have the relief valve directly connected to an external duct system. You are right, when the ambient temperature is 35, you can have a pressure that can rise up to and also a bit overcome the 70 bar. Thanks to our three safety levels, so envelope control, pressure switch, we are confident to avoid any unwanted release. So we don't expect that the relief valve will be activated. Also based on our experience. Anyway, due to the standard, you need the ducting system in order to convoy the CO2 outside the store.
Yeah, so it's something absolutely manageable with the standard safety rules. Architecture.
You have a dedicated port for ducting the CO2 outside.
Okay, considering the COP of the chiller and the COP of the EOS box, do we know which is the ideal water temperature?
The answer is yes. The ideal water temperature is between 8 and 12, and that's the reason I would say 8 and 10 if we consider the average latitude installation that we could find in Europe. And that's the reason why we strongly think that having our unit and so having a cold water loop makes us possible to create smart synergies with the HVAC system, because you are working with the same working temperature of HVAC utilities. And clearly, dealing with CO2 subcritical means efficiency itself, due to the fact that, as we have said, the CO2 has excellent thermodynamic properties. Clearly, you have the power consumption of a chiller. But if you consider the CO2 subcritical plus the benefit of the synergies, I think you can really find an optimal compromise.
Okay. Let's see if something else raises up.
How many minutes? I think 6 minutes left.
Yeah, we have still 6 minutes. By the way, we can remind that we are reachable directly or through our standard channel through the different sales companies in the different countries for whatever kind of questions and doubts.
So feel free to contact us. I see an end.
Yeah, but it's okay. So I guess that we end up for today. Thanks for listening to us. Stay tuned in our social channels to. For further information and for the next steps. And that's all. Have a good day. And always remind to think outside.